If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification.
Okay, students, let's welcome you all once again to lecture 23 of this switchgear protection series. So today we are taking another relay in distance relay, that is generic impedance relay. So you remember your universal torque characteristics, what you have studied in simple impedance relay. This was the universal torque characteristics. This was due to I, this was due to V, this was due to IV both. It was used in IDMT, it was used in directional relay. This can be used also to get two different fluxes. Okay, now what is the idea? So while discussing SIR, I was talking about every time in distance relay we will be playing around these equations only, and this constants K1, K2, K3, because K4 is always 0. So here what is done, suppose one fine morning you want to check something and you are playing with these variables, you take K1 positive and take K3 negative, K2 and K4 is 0. K4 is anyway we neglected. In earlier one, K1 was positive, K2 was negative. Now here K1 is positive, K3 is negative. That is, the operating torque here is the current. This is the operating torque, and the restraining one is the one that is holding the disc back, is the directional unit. Okay. So if this is the condition, if this way I connect the relay, so the relay in this condition will trip whenever my torque value T is greater than or equal to 0. So when it is greater than or equal to 0, this is greater than or equal to 0. When this equation is greater than 0, that is, this is positive and this is negative, because you have taken K3 as a minus negative value. So okay, that means your K1 IR square should be greater than this. So if you divide it both side by IR square and K3, then you will find the equation of this format. IR square will be gone, then VR by IR cos theta minus tau, K3 has gone that side. Okay. Now if you put K1 by K3 equal to Z set, that you will put K1 by K3 equal to Z set and VR by IR equal to ZR. Now the equation becomes something like this. ZR cos theta minus tau is less than equal to Z set. If this condition satisfies, then only the relay will trip. Otherwise, relay will not trip, because we have chosen T is greater than or equal to 0 only when this is true. So this becomes the trip characteristics of generic impedance relay. We will see how these characteristics shows in our plane in just a minute. So what we can say, generic impedance relay are similar to your overcurrent relay, but the restraint here is the directional restraint. In the what was SIR, it was also overcurrent relay type, but the restraint was due to voltage restraint. Here it is directional restraint. Now suppose this tau, I am making it 0 for easy understanding of this drawing and to discuss some special case. Suppose this tau is 0. So what will be your characteristics? ZR cos theta is less than equal to Z set, which is K1 by K3. What is ZR cos theta? You remember your impedance triangle. This is your impedance triangle. This is Z, this is R, this is X, and this is theta. So what is Z cos theta? Z cos theta is nothing but R, resistance. Okay. So Z cos theta is R. So if your resistance is less than your Z set value, the magnitude that we have set, then only it will trip. So if I want to draw it in RX plane, how does it will look like? You can see this is my RX plane, and this is the dot shape I have taken. This is just to give an idea. This is nothing to do with these characteristics. Z set, because Z set is a fixed value, so your Z set can have here, Z set can take this position, Z set can take any position. Now how your relay trips, that matters, because but Z set can take any value, because it is the magnitude you are fixing Z. R and X could be anything. So Z, and if the magnitude of mod Z is 5, if I say, that means 5 can be in any quadrant. So that is done. So that's why Z set can be any done. And this is the line impedance, ZL line. You have seen this impedance. This is the boundary. This is the reach point up to which you want to protect the line. And inside it, that was internal fault. Outside it was external fault. Suppose you measure a ZR value here. You will measure the ZR along this line only, because you are measuring the there is a fault in the line. So you are measuring the line impedance only, the impedance seen by the relay. So relay will see a impedance in this line only. If I assume it is a metallic fault, so only the line impedance will come, so it will follow this path only. Suppose it has reached here, suppose your ZR you got somewhere here. So what is ZR cos theta? ZR cos theta is this much, R, resistance value, because it is theta, so this is R. If this R is less than your ZZ, this is your ZZ is this one, then only it will trip. So suppose you measure ZR here, so what will your R, this is your R, this is still inside this, so your line will trip. So suppose you are measuring ZR here, so this, suppose this is your R. So this is outside the your ZZ parameter, so it will not trip, it will restrain. So which is the trip boundary between trip line and restrain line? Because you are measuring only R, so this becomes your boundary line. Whatever ZR measure, you take cos component, that is R. If it is less than this fixed value, because ZZ can be anywhere, so suppose your ZZ is here now, because I am comparing R only, that's why I kept my ZZ in R axis. So if my R is less than this ZZ value, then only it will trip. So this side is trip zone, this entire side, this entire zone of this line, this is trip zone, and this is restraint zone. So now you can understand, this is also known as resistance relay. You have heard about this relay. So generic impedance relay, that's why it is named as generic. You change the value of tau, it will give you new names. So if your tau is zero, then it becomes a resistance relay, because it is comparing only resistance, Z cos theta, whatever you are comparing, it is taking cos theta, whatever value you are calculating ZR, the relay is sensing cos component of that one, that is this lower portion R. If this is less than your set value in R, R means in X direction it is less than your set value is this much. Again I am saying set value can be anywhere. Here I am taking set value in X axis, because the measurement I am getting is only in X axis. So if it is less than that Z set value in the X axis, that's why it will be. So it will be a line perpendicular to X axis. Anything below, any resistance you calculate, if it is below Z set, then it will trip. Okay. Next, if I am TA, tau is now 90. Now how it will look like? The equation will look like something this. Cos you can take minus common, it will be 90 minus theta, so it is sin theta now. Now what is ZR sin theta again for impedance triangle? If ZR cos theta is your R, then ZR sin theta will be your X reactance. So that should be less than your ZZ. Again, if I draw the characteristics here, if it is RX plane, so again ZZ can be anywhere. But I will be calculating ZR here. Suppose I have calculated ZR here, and if I take sin, because it is theta, if I take sin theta, it will come here. So this is my X value. If this falls below your ZZ value, suppose this is my ZZ value, because ZZ can be anywhere now, anywhere. Here we are calculating X only. So I am putting ZZ on X, comparing ZZ on the X. What is the ZZ value in Y axis? Reactance value in Y axis. That's why it is written R, X. That's X I was talking about. So if it is less than that ZZ value, then it will trip. So anything falls below this line. Let me draw the boundary line here now. So this is the line. This is the trip character. Anything falls below this. Because whatever you are measuring, suppose, whatever ZR you are measuring, ultimately you will taking this component only. Because you will be comparing X only. Relay will take measurements and it will get ZR, and then from ZR it will take only X component, because it is taking only X component, it is looking at X component only. So if your X is less than your set value, that is the reactance value, this is the set value, this is the set value of ZZ in X dimension, because I am taking only in reactance part, so that's that reactance X, so that is your Y axis, then it will be a trip. So trip characteristics in RX plane, this is also known as reactance relay. I think you have heard about this one. This is reactance relay. If you liked the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.